Hello, this is ICR Tiger from thetradingtigers.com. Today, the 20th of May 2014, we're going to be looking at the FX pairs using Ichimoku on the 1 hour chart. Before we start, let's have a go through the disclaimer. Please read and go through at your own leisure, as well as the hypothetical performance. Okay, fine, so let's look at some charts. Okay, fine, so here we start with the euro dollar. We can't see really much happening in terms of strong movements for this. Currently the Shikau is in the cloud, price is going into the cloud, so we have to wait for the price to come out of the cloud, pass through the Tenkan-sen and Kijun-sen. Just to re-go over in terms of what the colors of the lines are, the blue line here, as you can see where my mouse is, this is the Shikau, that's the blue one. The Tenkan-sen, which is the yellow, that's the trigger line, and that's the Tenkan-sen. And the Kijun-sen, which is the red line, that's the baseline. The future Kumo and the current Kumo currently are green, and that is a bullish concept. And if you look at this other one, part of the Kumo, that's red, that is bearish, as you can see, price moving down. Okay, fine, so let's move on. Euro dollar, please look at this trade. I entered this trade at 14692, that's 1.4692, and the stop level was 1.4630. We're already in profit of 73 pips. Price triggered at 7 o'clock last night, that's GMT time, and we used it as a breakout strategy, like an ultra conservative strategy, and prices just rocketed up, which is quite positive for us. Okay, fine, if we move across now to the Euro CAD, we can see no difference, kind of consolidation kind of pattern emergence over here. We go to the Euro Pound. Euro Pound have just taken a trade on the short side as a Kumo break. Although price has just broken out the cloud, the Shikau is actually above its corresponding candle. It should actually be below. It's a very aggressive entry which I've taken, and Tenkan-sen will come out of the cloud, as well as the Kijun-sen will also come out slowly, but I've just put quite an aggressive entry on that, and that the stop entry was at 81.43 and stop level 81.57. and if we can have a look, the level is 14 pip stop loss, so okay, not so much to lose. Now let's move to the Euro Japanese Yen. Just wanted to show to you this particular trade. Sorry, I just have to move the chart over. We had entered at 139.175, and initially our stop was at 140.232, and subsequently we've been trailing our stop all the way down by the Kumo, and final stop currently now is at 139.346, and that is quite a tight stop loss, but you know, we'd like it tight. So that's about 19 pips stop loss, which is pretty good for us. And as you can see, price has gone through the cloud, gone in the cloud, touched the top, but didn't stop us out. That's the advantage of having I'll just make that a little bit bigger for you so you can actually see. And then price hit the top of the cloud after going through the cloud, out the cloud, and that strong movement down. Could possibly take another entry there as a short side. We see a twist emergence over here, so what we'll do, we'll mark that there for you so you can actually view accordingly. Okay, fine. So that was the Euro Japanese. And then let's move to the US Japanese pair. US Japanese. US Japanese. Okay, fine. What do we see? Do we see anything? No. That should be a stop, actually. Okay. So we don't see anything emergence right now. We can probably look for this potential twist area here. Price has gone into the cloud, come out past the Tenkan-sen, but you can see price and the Shikao are just holding each other together down. That's right. So that's that. Okay, fine. Let's move now to the next chart, US Swiss. Once again, price has gone into this kind of consolidation kind of concept. Price has popped out through the cloud. Well, we can see future Kumo is bullish. That could be our signal where things could actually move up a little bit forward. So what we could do, we could probably look to, in terms of a breakout around this location, because the cow has pushed all its way forward above. And although the future Kumo, current Kumo is bearish, that by the time it's probably reached here around, what time is that? About 5:30, we could probably see a breakthrough. And if not, we could be ultra conservative and enter on the high here. The price difference is will be only 20 pips. So if we want to be a little bit conservative, we can take it on the high here. So let's put an entry now at, take it to 20, we'll take it to buy 20 GTC, put that as a stop, or we'll take it there, put it on the ask price, because that's important. Now, that's where our entry will be. Our entry is going to be at 0.8938. That's our entry, traders, and our stop level is gonna be quite tight. And we're gonna bring it down here. We're gonna put it just below these kind of we're gonna put it on the bid price. Please remember that it's gonna be trading at about 37 pips. That's our stop loss. So the stop loss level is 89.8901. Okay, so that's where we put our stop. Okay, so the next one is the US CAD. What can we see here? Shikao has gone into the cloud. Not really helping us for anything. Future Kumo and current Kumo are both bearish, so not a lot we can expect. We can see the twist here, which can occur. Let's just mark that down. Oops. Mark that down there. And the price has popped through the Kumo. This isn't really 100% flat bottom, but don't be fooled in terms of price pushing up through here for a long position. We're probably we can probably put some markers there. You can see all these flatness. Probably just sit and wait and see what happens with that potential trade. Okay, fine. So what's the next one is the pound Aussie. If we look at the pound Aussie, we took this trade at 1.8020, and our stop level has not been marked on our chart yet. Our stop is at 17919. That's the stop level, and that's how many pips is that for us? That's 98 pips. Currently we're 114 pips in profit, which is not a bad trade. If you imagine we start this last night at 7 p.m. and the price has just rocketed up, and you can see we had taken this trade based on an ultra conservative strategy because everything was just positive for us, so that's why we put this entry. And you can see from this area our future Kumo was very flatlined. Well, it was flatlined, but we were seeing this kind of area occurrence on the future Kumo. If you look at the future Kumo, it was pointing upwards, and then subsequently, as you can see, it's just pointing upwards. It's still pointing upwards. No harm to even enter on this trade even now, because if we meet the 200-300 rule broken down into necessary proportions, we've still got an opportunity, if possible, to enter. 65.90, very tight right now. I think we probably just missed it, tell you the truth, to re-enter now, or to do another entry. And also, if you can look down further, there was a crossover which happened, which was a valid and a very strong entry for the Tenkan-sen Kijun-sen cross, which happened above the Kumo, and all the parameters had met. So we had missed the actual crossover, which was a valid signal, and it would have anyhow, we had taken a conservative ultra conservative entry, and that also we missed out like 58 pips. So anyhow, that is how it happens. So the next one is the pound dollar. As you can see, pound dollar, what can we tell from this? We look at what happened there for that cross up, that twist here, and see how that happened. And you can see there's a twist here just about to happen, which can give us some sort of idea. By the time this twist has occurred, perhaps we're going to see price actually starting to fall down. As you can see, all the parameters are heading south, so just bear in mind around this area something to occur, and we probably can take some sort of short positions later on. Let's have a look for different levels where we could actually be. Yeah, or even here. Right, okay, fine, let's move on. Pound Japanese yen, as you can see, right now we kind of had a bearish kind of move all the way down, as you can see, and price has just kind of moved down like this and then gone into some sort of consolidation, not giving us any sort of good signal in terms of any long or short. So probably be at the sidelines right now with regards to this potential, this instrument. And Aussie US, sorry, I have to bring it over again. Aussie US, we've taken an entry, we've put a order entry to come short at this low here at 0.9325, which was finally penetrated several days ago. So we put that order in at 15th of May, and last night, as you can see, we've been able to go take our entry to go short here, and as you can see how prices have just rocketed all the way down, and currently we're 47 pips in profit, which is pretty good for us. You can see all the current Kumo is a little bit indecisive of really where it wants to go, but we put a marker here at that particular twist. We can probably expect to see some movement down at that particular time. And look at the future Kumo, is very 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 bearish all the way down, so we can expect to see some moves accordingly. Wait to see what happens in this particular part of the candle if we're going to be able to retrace all the way back up to the Kijusan line, which probably that level probably seems to be quite a good level. If possible, there could be a possible another entry to occur around at that level. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to put an entry here at to sell at, in fact, what I'll do, I'll sell at that level, which is here, right? And I'll put a GTC that's good to cancel. And now what I'll do, I'll put our stop loss still at the same spot. Okay, so that's a 59 pip stop loss. Okay, fine, so let's just put another marker there for an entry. Put that entry 2, return that to entry 1. Okay, fine. So, okay, fine. So the last one we're going to show is the Kiwi Japanese Yen. And as you know, we're in a trade for another strategy on this, but you know, we have put our markers here. Let's just see if it's been triggered. Yes, it was triggered, as you can see. We were triggered here at 87.332, and the price, of course, has subsequently gone down. That's a short sell for the Kiwi Japanese Yen. So we're at 25 pips in profit. Our stop loss is at 88.17, and that's let's just mark that there. Get the stop level in play. And what we're going to do, we're just going to measure that how much the pip values are. How much is our stop loss? 79 pips. So with 79 pips, we're going to be able to retrace down, pull our stop down, you know, later on. We can actually see exactly what time we're going to be breaking even, which is good about Ichimoku. If we're still in the trade, we're probably going to be by tomorrow still having some small risk, but not that much risk. So we're looking for some more strong movements downwards. Okay, fine. So that's me, traders. That's ICR Tiger from thetradingtigers.com. Thank you. Bye-bye.